गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू टुडेज क्लास। यस्टरडे वी हैव फिनिश्ड अप टू पेज नंबर 76 एंड वी हैव लर्न दैट फैब्रिक इज मेड अप ऑफ यार्न एंड यार्न इज मेड अप ऑफ फाइबर एंड वी ऑल्सो लर्न दैट वी गेट फाइबर फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एज वेल एज फ्रॉम एनिमल्स एंड दे आर कॉल्ड एज नेचुरल फाइबर्स एंड द फाइबर्स नाउअडेज दे आर preparing by using some chemicals, so these are called as artificial fibers. Now characteristics of fibers: collect some natural and artificial fabrics and observe the following characteristics. So here they have given table number 2, the characters of the natural fabric as well as artificial fabric. Water absorbing nature. So if you take a cotton fabric and you dip in the water, it immediately absorbs the water. So water absorbing nature, then you have to take in the natural fabric. That means natural fabric is having the capacity to absorb the water, whereas artificial fabric does not absorb the water. Next, time taken to dry, more time. Natural fabric takes more time to dry and artificial fabric will dry soon, because it does not absorb more water, so it gets dry very soon. And smell while burning. Natural fabric while burning, it does not give more smell, whereas artificial fabric while burning will give pungent smell. Result after burning: ash will be formed. Stretching capacity of yarn, smoothness. So this you have to fill up the table number 2. 3 I have explained, more 3 you have to write, and this is the homework for you. Fill up the table number 2. This is your homework. Once and twice I am saying the homeworks and some are not doing it. Now which step after filling the table we have to answer the following questions: which type of fabrics are smooth in nature? Which type of fabrics dry in short time? Artificial fabrics will dry in short time. And smoothness is natural fabric is more smooth. Do you find any relation between smoothness and time to dry? Yes, the water it absorbs more will take more time to dry, at the same time the smoothness is having. Next, which fabrics gives ash when they are burn? Artificial fabrics will give pungent smell and natural fabrics will not give pungent smell and they will get ash after burning. Now about natural fibers. So silk fabrics are slippery and shiny in nature. Yes, the silk that is obtained from the silkworm is very slippery and shiny, whereas cotton fabrics may be coarse as well as smooth. Cotton are may be coarse and may be smooth. When we burn fabric made up of artificial fibers, it gives a pungent smell. Now we'll talk about the natural fibers. Cotton, jute, wool and silk are some common examples of natural fibers. That means they are obtained from the plants and animals. In this section, we will discuss cotton and jute in detail. So in this chapter, we are going to learn in detail about the cotton and jute. Cotton is obtained from cotton balls or cotton fruits. So did you see cotton plant anytime? If you go to the village, you can see. So they look like flowers. When the cotton ball is open, it looks just like a flower. So it is obtained from a cotton balls, and you can call it also cotton fruits. Usually cotton plants are cultivated in black soil. So cotton plants, mostly they are cultivated in black soil, not in the red soil. In our state, cotton crop is widely grown in the districts like Warangal, Adilabad and Nalgonda. So if you have any relatives in the Warangal, you can just go to the fields and you can see. Mostly in Warangal, Adilabad and Nalgonda, the cotton is widely grown. Look at the Telangana state map and list out the places where cotton is grown. So you have to find out some more states that produce cotton. Cotton yarn. Collect cotton balls from nearby houses or cotton growing fields. Remove seeds from the cotton balls and separate cotton. You can see in the figure number 4 the cotton balls. So you can see some seeds in the cotton. So first what they are asking, to collect the cotton balls and you have to separate the cotton from the seeds. Take a small piece of cotton, observe it using a magnifying lens or under a microscope. What do you observe? You will see small hairy structures. These are the fibers of cotton. After maturing, cotton balls burst and open. And then we can see the white colored strand of cotton fibers. Cotton is usually picked by hands. When cotton wool is separated from the seeds, it is called ginning. So when the cotton plants are growing, after some time, when it gets matured, the cotton ball will just open and the cotton will come outside. So this is a cotton that is obtained from the cotton plant, and you can see seeds inside the cotton. So removing like this cotton, that is separating the cotton from the cotton balls. So in this process we have to remove the seeds like this. So these are the seeds, they are in brown and black color. If you observe it carefully, it will be black and brown color. So these are the seeds of the cotton plant. And when you take out cotton from these cotton plants, you can see some hairy like structures. Even with your naked eye, you can see, you observe it in your home, they are very small hairy like structures. These are called as the fibers of cotton, that is cotton fibers. These are called as cotton fibers. So now the process of separating the seeds from the cotton is called ginning. This method is called as ginning. Separating the seeds like this from the cotton is called ginning. And this cotton balls from the plants can be picked by hand. It can be taken out with the help of hand, not from with the machine. So making yarn from cotton fiber. Now we have learned that we get fibers like this, hairy like structures are called fibers from the cotton plants. From this fiber, how the yarn is prepared? How is the yarn made from these cotton fibers? We are going to see now. Cotton fiber is collected after removing the seeds from the cotton ball. So the cotton that we get in the shops, it does not contain any seeds. That means they'll remove all the seeds and they'll separate the cotton. Cotton that we get from the shop does not contain any seeds. They'll separate the cotton from the seeds and they will sell it, and they'll comb it and they'll make it clean without any dust, impurity, particles. So now how do the yarn is prepared from this fiber? Let us learn. Cotton fiber is collected after removing the seeds from the cotton ball. So what they'll do, these fibers, they will collect it after removing the seeds from the cotton ball. This cotton fiber is cleaned. So what they'll do, first they'll clean this cotton fiber, then they will wash it, and then they will comb it. How do we comb our hair? Like that, they'll comb the cotton fibers neatly. This fine cotton fiber is used to make cotton yarn. Then they will use this cotton fiber to make yarn. Yarns are dyed and coated with chemicals. Then what happens next process? The yarn is dyed and then they will be coated with chemicals. Then they become strong enough to make fabrics. If you take this fiber like this, and can you prepare a cloth with this? It will be not strong. So they will wash it, they'll comb it, they'll dye, and they'll use some chemicals, and they'll make the fibers very strong. Then with this fiber they will make a fabric. So this is how they prepare cotton yarn from using cotton fibers. So we have learned that they'll remove the cotton seeds from the cotton and they'll make the cotton yarn. So this is enough for today. Your homework already I have told. Fill up the table number 2 and once again go through the textbook. Thank you.